exciting news! We've launched our new podcast, Eons, Mysteries of Deep Time. On the podcast, we'll dig into the past and explore the greatest mysteries of natural history. From the dawn of the dinosaurs to downtown modern Los Angeles, we're covering what we know and what we still don't know about the history of life on Earth. Look for Eons, Mysteries of Deep Time, wherever you listen to podcasts, and be sure to let us know what you think. Links are in the description.
In 2002, researchers studying fossils from Transylvania, dating to around 70 million years ago, reported an unusual discovery. They were analyzing a few big bone fragments, bits of skull and humerus, which had first been described a decade earlier. At the time, they were thought to belong to a huge theropod dinosaur, possibly some kind of tyrannosaur, on account of their enormous size. But upon their reanalysis, the researchers realized that these bones weren't those of a theropod at all, or any other kind of dinosaur. Instead, they belonged to a colossal pterosaur, easily one of the largest ever discovered. They named it Hotsagopteryx. Its huge size wasn't the only remarkable thing about it. Unlike other pterosaurs that had a generally slender build, the bones of this specimen seemed to be uniquely stocky, robust, and built for strength. And its initial mistaken identity as a giant theropod is pretty understandable, because today, it's thought that Hotsagopteryx was basically a pterosaur playing the role of a giant theropod. As it turns out, its bizarre proportions were likely the result of a particular ecological situation, one that turned a pterosaur into a giant apex predator, and the dinosaurs it hunted into dwarfs. In the late Cretaceous period, Europe was a fragmented archipelago, a collection of islands, some large, some small, that had become isolated due to rising sea levels. And while Europe's fossil record from this time is often patchy, the Hotsig Basin region of Romania, where Hotsagopteryx was discovered, has provided some key insights into the area's weird animal life. Back then, the basin was one of the archipelago's islands, Hotsig Island, which was a little smaller than Ireland in size and 200 to 300 kilometers away from the nearest landmass. As far back as 100 years ago, paleontologists excavating in the basin realized there was something strange about its dinosaurs. They seemed miniaturized. It was proposed that Hotsig dinosaurs shrank in response to the limited resources available on the island in a process called insular dwarfism. Now, you might have heard of this before. It's happened many times over the history of life when large animals found themselves isolated on islands and rapidly shrank in response. And this resulted in islands of things like dwarf mammoths and hippos. But these examples are relatively recent, within the last few 100,000 years or so. Hotsig Island was the first example of this process affecting dinosaurs in the much deeper past. And the fossils we found from the region, as well as the fossils we haven't found, paint a picture of an ecosystem that was just the weirdest. One that created a unique opportunity for a pterosaur to become the apex predator. Among Hotsig's strange fauna were tiny sauropods. Now, sauropods are generally known for being some of the biggest land animals of all time, sometimes growing more than 30 meters long. But the sauropods from Hotsig Island shrank to only around 6 meters long, making them some of the smallest species of sauropods ever found. And as small as these sauropods were, they're still the biggest dinosaurs we know of from the island, because insular dwarfism seems to have affected many of the island's other herbivorous dinosaurs too, like the around 4-meter-long dwarf hadrosaur called Telmatosaurus. It was around half the size of your average mainland hadrosaur. And you'd think that these little dinosaurs would have been easy prey for large or even medium-sized carnivorous dinosaurs. After all, we know many predatory theropods were at the top of the food chain across much of the rest of the planet at the time, like T-Rex in North America and Carnotaurus in Argentina. Yet we found no evidence to date of any big theropods from Hotsig. And this suggests that the ecological niche of apex predator was empty, waiting to be occupied by something large, mobile, and powerful enough to fill it. Enter Hotsagopteryx, a pterosaur with an estimated wingspan of up to 12 meters and a skull nearly 3 meters long. One pterosaur expert even described it as a giant mix of a shoebill stork, a ground hornbill, and the Terminator. The idea that Hotsagopteryx was basically a pterosaur turned T-Rex was first proposed in 2017 by researchers studying one of its neck vertebrae. The bone was particularly short, wide, thick, and robust compared to other known giant pterosaurs. And this led them to think that while Hotsagopteryx was truly massive, its neck would have actually been proportionally quite short, but thick and heavily muscled, trading length for strength. By modeling the biomechanics of Hotsagopteryx's neck, they concluded that it might be the strongest of any known pterosaur. This would allow it to withstand the kind of stresses experienced by a terrestrial predator that had used its enormous head to bite, bash, and stab prey that was too big to swallow whole, like dwarf dinosaurs. And while a huge, chunky pterosaur might seem like it should be pretty clumsy on the ground, it's been suggested in recent years that pterosaurs were actually capable and efficient walkers. Analysis of fossil trackways and skeletal features of other giant pterosaurs suggests they weren't catching food in flight. Instead, many would have been terrestrial generalist foragers that ate small animals and scavenged on carrion. But Hotsagopteryx is thought to have taken this lifestyle up another notch, taking down proportionally much larger prey than any other known pterosaur, thanks to its uniquely robust build. Based on its size, Hotsagopteryx would have probably been big and powerful enough to prey on all of the island's known dinosaurs, other than maybe the fully grown dwarf sauropods. Now you might be thinking, if Hotsagopteryx was a terrestrial apex predator and had such a massive stocky build, could it still fly? Well, there are reasons to think, yeah, it probably could. Based on the few bone fragments we have from its wings, they seem to have still been functional. The proportions of its humerus matched those of a normal flying pterosaur. And despite being so robust, it actually would have been surprisingly light. The internal structure of its bones have a series of weight-saving adaptations, like tiny and densely packed hollow structures called alveoli that kind of look like polystyrene, rigid but light. In fact, its weight has been estimated at only around 250 kilograms, That's an animal the size of a giraffe with the wingspan of a small plane, weighing only roughly about the same as a large black bear. So it seems that Hotsagopteryx landed in an evolutionary sweet spot, able to grow big and powerful enough to hunt dwarf dinosaurs, while still probably staying lightweight enough to fly. And flight might have been a key factor that allowed Hotsagopteryx to get and stay so gigantic, while many of the island's other animals shrank. If it could fly, then its food resources wouldn't have been limited to only one island the way they were for the dwarf dinosaurs. Hotsagopteryx could have ranged across the European archipelago, avoiding insular dwarfism. And this also makes Hotsagopteryx not just a contender for the most imposing pterosaur of all time, but also one of the largest things that ever flew. The largest flying animal around today, the wandering albatross, has a wingspan of up to 3.7 meters. Hotsagopteryx's was a little over 3 times that. And throughout the entire fossil record, it's rivaled by only 2 other pterosaurs, one of which was Quetzalcoatlus from North America, which was also enormous, but much more slender. Despite rising to the top of the food chain and ruling Hotsag Island for millions of years, and probably the rest of the European archipelago too, Hotsagopteryx's reign came to a catastrophic end 66 million years ago. Like the dwarf dinosaurs it preyed upon, it didn't survive the mass extinction at the end of the Cretaceous. But the story of its rise shows us that being at the right place at the right time can be a major driving force in evolution, one that could turn a pterosaur into the Hotsag Island version of a T-Rex. We've got to thank this month's terrific eontologists: Chase Archambault Colton, Mikhail Afridi, Annie and Eric Higgins, John Davidson Ng, Jake Hart, and Melanie Lamb Carnivale. Become an eonite at patreon.com/eons, and you can get fun perks like submitting a fun joke for us to read, like this one from Matt Hepler. What do you call a pterosaur that can't fly? A pterosaur. From a pterosaur. And as always, thanks for joining me in the Constantine Haase studio. Subscribe at youtube.com/eons for more evolutionary escapades.